What's up, y'all? This is your boy Scotty, and you're watching my review on Love and Hip Hop Atlanta Season 3, Episode 11. What is up, y'all? The last time y'all really seen me was when I did my video with Justin J. Justin was here last week. We spent some time together. We was hanging out or whatnot, and we decided that we were going to go ahead and give y'all another collaboration video because, you know, you guys like it when we come together from time to time and do a video. The first time we did a video together was during the Thanksgiving holidays, and this time we're doing it during the 4th of July week. So, I must say, before I get into the review, I just want to thank Justin for even allowing me to be a part of it. That video has brought me brand new subscribers. It's pushed me to like 7,900 subscribers. I was at 7,700 when before I did that video, but it's given me like over 200 new subscribers, and that's all because of Justin. So I want to thank you guys. I want to first of all thank Justin for allowing me to be a part of it, and I also want to thank you guys for supporting me and Justin. I always have to reiterate all the time that this is not some, you know, some YouTube bullshit. Me and Justin are actually real friends. We have real problems, real issues, not with each other, but we discuss real problems, real issues. We come to each other for advice all the time. So what you see is what you get. No, me and Justin are not in a relationship. We have never had sex. We've never seen each other naked. I am not in love with Justin. Do I love Justin? Of course I do. He's like an older brother to me, but we would never be in a relationship at all. No. And that's not in a mean way. We're just friends. Like, just because two gay guys come together on a video does not mean they're fucking. Like, why can't two gay YouTubers get together without the notion of fucking with each other or sleeping around? Like, I mean, there's a lot of gay YouTubers out there that really don't support each other, and we're one of the two that do. So that's pretty much what it is. And don't pit us up against each other. I've seen certain comments, well, I like Justin by himself, or Scotty was boring me. Baby, if you don't like it, don't say nothing, because me and Justin will continue to film together. And like in the future, I think the next video we'll do together is one we'll probably do the next time we do a video. I think Adrian will be a part of it the next time. We're already discussing, me and Justin are discussing, you know, whether we're gonna go visit Adrian or if we're gonna go visit Justin, or they're gonna come visit me. It's one or the other. So we're gonna continue to film with each other. We're gonna continue to collaborate, and that's just that. It is what it is. I might be doing a video with Jamar soon, so who knows. So let's just get into the video. I just had to rant and ramble about that, but just had to let y'all know that I love Justin J. That's my homie, that's my friend, it's like my family. It is what it is. So let's just move on with the review. Okay, let's get some of the boring stuff out the way first. Kalina. I love Kalina and her Welch's Grape Juice ass hair. I love her. I love her personality. She reminds me a lot of K. Michelle. And I think that they bring her in to replace K. Michelle. And I think she's the only person that can really replace her as far as I'm concerned. This whole Kalina, Ashley's storyline is pretty much coming to a close. Her husband pretty much told Kalina that he can't deal with having a marriage and having a homie on the side to fuck. He can't deal with it, and he's finally being honest about it, and Kalina didn't have no other choice but to respect it. As a man, I understand him, you know what I'm saying? Like, who would want that woman to be, you know, like I said, a lot of men would love to have their women, you know, fuck another bitch in front of them or have a threesome. A lot of men would love to do that, but then you got some men that ain't down for that shit, and Tony tried to be supportive of Kalina's, but at the end of the day, he really wasn't down for the shit. So I respect him enough to come to her and say, we need to focus on our relationship, we need to focus on our son, and focus on getting your music back out there. And I think that Kalina has a chance, because believe it or not, even though she hasn't seen much success of her own, the last time she seen a little bit of success was with Dirty Money, but I do think that Kalina does have the potential to, you know, to do what K. Michelle did, you know what I'm saying? Like, take this platform, use it as a tool to get yourself back out there, and I think that she has what it takes. She is pretty dope as a songwriter, and I would love to see her go places. So they pretty much deaded that shit, and Kalina pretty much told Ashley that she just want to be her friend, she will always love her, but as far as them turning up and getting down with each other, they can't do that shit no more. So that's pretty much what that was. So Tammy and Waka Flocka, they decided that they wanted to get married on their own terms. Waka doesn't want no big ass lavish wedding, so he wants to go ahead and get the job done. They got the job done. So they met up with each other's mothers, they met up with Mona, and they met up with Deb, and they pretty much told them that they're married. Now Deb felt some type of way because she just lost her her son weeks prior to that, and she wanted to be a part of this situation. She wanted to be a part of giving her son away because her children are her babies. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't matter how old they get, they will always be her babies, and I understand that completely. You know what I'm saying? So I get where Deb coming from. She wanted to be a part of the moment, and you know, she probably felt like Tammy and Walker were being selfish. You know, Tammy was trying to convince her that yes, you're gaining something, which Deb completely understood, but as a mother, she was pretty much saying that she wanted to be a part of that. She wanted to give her son to Tammy. She felt like that would have been the most appropriate thing, and Mona also wanted to be a part of that big moment between them. So I got it. It was pretty much of a, you know, even though I do feel like Tammy and Waka Flocka are boring as fuck on this show, they do have real life relationships. It doesn't seem so scripted. So let's get into Erica and Erica Pink Eye and Scrappy. They talk about the situation. Scrappy wants to get back with Bambi. He wants to make things work with the Bambi. So he wants to cut Erica Pink Eye off. Erica Pink Eye ain't trying to hit it. She talked about some drunken ass text messages, some flirtatious text messages that Scrappy sent her. And then it all goes haywire. She gets all upset and this and that. And I don't know what happened, but I do remember reading this on TMZ that she did try to attack Scrappy at a restaurant when they were talking. Now, I read that like a month or two ago. So all these things that we're seeing now have been filmed recently, either in April or May, like two months ago tops. So all this shit that we're seeing now is pretty recent. So from what I read on TMZ, that's the reason, that altercation right there was the reason why they want to beef up security, because of that altercation between Erica Pink Eye and Scrappy. And she talking about he would never get this pussy. Bitch, you was willing to give it to him. That's why you're mad at Bambi right now. You was willing to give him the pussy. So what the fuck are you talking about? Now you want to go over there and start crying to Mama D about the situation, telling Mama D what the hell y'all was dealing with and all of that shit. You know that you want Scrappy to fuck. You know you want a Scrappy for yourself. So please have a motherfucking seat. You know what I'm saying? Like, Scrappy don't want you. He want to be with Bambi, and you already knew that. So just have a seat. Like, the way that Erica Pink Eye really be acting a fool makes me not feel for her at all. Like, I'm looking at Shay all over again. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, I'm just not feeling the bitch. I don't give a fuck about her tears, and I'm sick of Mama D always over there with the side bitch all the time. That's one motherfucking mama that I have ever seen in my life that always sympathized with the side bitch. I ain't never met nobody like that at all. So this whole thing with Stevie J, Benzino, and Althea. Now, Benzino and Althea keeps talking about the Stevie J shit and how he won't admit to it. And like I said, I don't think that Althea has any reason to lie on her pussy. I've heard about niggas lying on their dick, but I ain't never heard of no bitch lying on their pussy. And I just don't think that she is lying on her pussy. I think that Stevie J is just lying so he won't have to deal with the situation between him and Jocelyn. Jocelyn's still mad at Stevie J for not telling the truth. But my whole point about it is, you calling Althea hoe, and you sitting up here saying that you don't want to be married to a cheater. But like I said in the last video, you lose him the same way you got him, bitch. You stole him from Mimi and you thought that shit was cute. I'm a slut monkey for your baby daddy and you hate it. Well, guess what? Althea was a slut monkey for your quote-unquote husband and you hate it. So now you want to be mad. And just like Althea said, Steve J might as well just own up to his shit and just deal with this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck is you lying about it for? You don't want to deal with Jocelyn. You don't want to deal with the Wrath of Benzino. But I don't know why you're talking about the Wrath of Benzino, because Benzino don't give a fuck. He's let it go. He's in love with Althea. He wants to be with Althea, and that's that. So I don't see what the fuck you keep lying about the situation for. Just deal with it. You know what I'm saying? So Jocelyn meets up with Messy Red, and she pretty much tells her that she wants to go out of town and because she don't want to deal with Stevie. But you sitting up here being mad about what Stevie did. He been treating you like that. And at the end of the day, you're going to go right back to him. But recently we've seen in the blogs and in the tabloids that they ain't no longer together and all that shit. We've seen all this shit before. And at the end of the day, they'll be right back together. If they don't be back together, then somebody must have smartened up and left the other one. But like I said, they always end up back together. This shit don't be for real. But then, you know, we see Althea and Benzino get engaged and all that stuff. It was a pretty sweet moment, whatever. So, y'all, I don't know, this episode was boring to me. I wasn't feeling it at all. It's just not good. Now, next week gonna be pretty good. Kay Michelle gonna be back. It's gonna be a lot of things going on with Carly and Althea at the apology party. It's going to be a pretty good episode, in my opinion. I think it's going to be a nice little episode this week. They need it, because we almost at the end of this season. This episode was episode 11, and next week going to be episode 12, and then we're going to have, like, let's see, 13, 14, 15, and then the two-part reunion show, and then after that, we're probably going to be getting into Love & Hip Hop LA. And I think we should be seeing some previews to that shit soon, because it's pretty much apparent that Love & Hip Hop LA will be coming this summer. So, here we go with that. So, follow me on Twitter at Mr. Still Standing, Mr. Underscore Still Standing without the G. Follow me on Instagram at Rebellious Underscore Scotty, and be sure to follow my Facebook fan page at Team Scotty. And you guys, I am out of here. Shout out to Dustin Ross Said. Make sure y'all subscribe to him. And whenever y'all watch one of Dustin Ross' videos, be sure to say that Scotty slash Mr. Still Standing sent me. And I'm out of here, y'all.